To link your Excel workbook to a Word document is very simple. In fact, why do you want to do that? Well, I'm looking at my monthly sales here. I could create a table, and in this table I could have the totals and maybe different formulas and functions. But remember, for the most part, Microsoft Word, when you create tables, you want to keep it simplistic if you're going to be adding or subtracting cells. If you have more complex formulas and functions, you want to obviously do it in Microsoft Excel, and if you're not familiar with it, you want to watch the training videos on it. But that way, I can perform my complex calculations in Excel and then just simply insert the Excel worksheet in here as a table and have it link, so any changes I make in Excel will automatically update here in what looks to be a table, but that's actually linked to Excel. For example, to get started, I'm going to minimize the document here and go to my exercise folder to show you there's my monthly sales workbook. Double click to open it up. And I kept it something simple here. I've got my gummy monthly sales, and you can see that there's no borders in there. If I want to bring back the borders, I can select it and then click the paint bucket and say I don't want any color, because before it was in white. But I could say no fill and I get my borders back. So that's what I'm going to be linking to and inserting into my Word document. So I'm going to close out, be sure to save my work, click yes. And I'll close out of the exercise folder here. Go back to my Word document, and then I'm going to come to the Insert tab over to the text group. I can click on the Object button, or I can click on the drop-down arrow and still select Object. I want this from a file that's already been created here, so I'm going to click on the Create from File. I don't want something new. I'm going to browse for that file. It's on my desktop, remember, my exercise folder, and it's my monthly sales. I'll double-click on that. And then I want to make sure that I link to the file, so any changes I make in Excel or somebody else does, it should update in the table it will display to that Excel workbook in my Word document. If I click OK, it adds the table here. Of course, I can come and delete that. The other option you have is when you click on the Object button and we create from file and we browse to the desktop to our exercise folder. It's the monthly sales. Link to it. The other option was display as icon. If I choose display as icon, that's all it does, is it just displays the Excel workbook icon there, which you could double click and open it up. But in the Word document, if I do a sales presentation or I want to print this off and hand it off to somebody, I don't want this little icon. I actually want the table. So I'll uncheck that and click OK. So we're back to square one here. Now, I can't make any changes to this table because this is linked to Excel. The only change you can make to this table is to change Excel. And you can do that one of two ways. You can either double click on the table here, opens up Excel, close out, or when in doubt, right click and go to Linked Worksheet Object and then to edit the link. I prefer double clicking, but you can do it either way. Okay, so any changes I make in this Excel workbook, like for example, if I select all this and I say I don't want any color, in fact, let me move this over to the side so you can see what's happening here, how quickly it updates. Click on the bucket and I can choose different colors. See that? Fantastic. I can even choose white, so it doesn't have any borders there. And let's make some changes. Let's say for April it wasn't 200, let's say it was 150. The moment I hit the tab key, it automatically updates the table here. So when I'm finished, I can go ahead and close out. Of course, be sure to save your work. The other way of updating it is when in doubt, you can always right click and say update link. So it'll update any changes made in Excel, but as you already saw, it updates it when you have both open here at the same time. Okay, let's create a chart out of this. I'm going to click at the end of the table and hit enter a couple of times and then insert a chart. Now when I insert the chart, I can't link it to this table at all. And I can't link it to the Excel workbook that's linked to this table. It's got to be a completely separate database. For example, I'm going to come here, go up to the Insert tab to the Illustrations and click on the Chart button. I'm going to stick with my column chart, that's the easiest, and click OK. It does two things. First of all, it inserts a generic chart and it gives me a generic workbook. Now, like I said, this is not going to link to anything. You actually have to start from scratch. So if I want the data from here, well, I can't get it from there because it's in the Excel workbook. I have to open up the Excel workbook here. So I'm just going to minimize this down to my taskbar right here, okay? Or if I wanted to, I could close out of it, but it's best to minimize it because when I double click to open this up, now I have two workbooks opened up, Excel workbooks. I have my one to my chart here, and then over here I can click on this button to my monthly sales. It's linked to my table. So all I have to do is select it, click on the copy button, but you know what? I don't want the title in there. I just want the data here. So I'll select it again and click the copy button one more time, so the marching ants are just around this selection here. If I don't have them both open where I can click copy here, and then I come and open up the other one, it's not going to work when it comes to pasting. It won't give me the paste button. So just leave both of them up. going to come up here in the upper left-hand corner in cell A1 and paste, and it will paste down and out, so it pushes it out. And as you recall, if you watch the other training videos for Microsoft Excel, that when we're creating charts, basically it's got this blue border, thin blue border, everything within it is going to be within your chart. So if I move this around, see there's category 4 right there, isn't there? So I'll bring it back up, and I don't want category 4 in there. I can do one of two things. I can either select it and delete it, or I can click out and grab this little corner handle of the blue and move it up one. So the data's still there, but when I move it out of the way, the data isn't in the chart. And if I want to expand it more, I can, of course, click it out. But just keep in mind that, as you recall from the other training videos, that this corner doesn't go diagonally. You have to do it. You have to either go out or down. And then once you go down, then you can click it and drag it out. You have to go one way or the other, and then once you're done with that, then you can go the other way. So once I'm finished, I can go ahead and close out of there. And of course, this is my monthly sales to my table, which has nothing to do, I'll close out of that, with my chart here. Two separate Excel workbooks, two separate data fields. Although they look the same, don't they? Well, that's the whole point, the master of illusion here. Just know that if you want the data here in your table to be representative, or any data, just make sure that you insert your chart and it gives you that Excel workbook that you paste, or just type in that Excel workbook. In fact, if we want to make changes to your chart, you want to, when in doubt, right-click and always edit the data, and it brings up your workbook. And then you can make changes in here. So if 800 is too high, and I'm looking at May, so 800 for the south. So if I come in here and say, well, you'll be 50, and I hit the tab key, then I can move it out of the way. Well, there I am. It's increments of 50 here. So it's right at the margin. Okay, let's create a chart out of this. I'm going to click at the end of the table and hit enter a couple of times, and then insert a chart. Now, when I insert the chart, I can't link it to this table at all. And I can't link it to the Excel workbook that's linked to this table. It's got to be a completely separate database. For example, I'm going to come here, go up to the Insert tab, to the Illustrations, and click on the Chart button. I'm going to stick with my column chart. That's the easiest, and click OK. It does two things. First of all, it inserts a generic chart, and it gives me a generic workbook. Now, like I said, this is not going to link to anything. You actually have to start from scratch. So if I want the data from here, well, I can't get it from there because it's in the Excel workbook. I have to open up the Excel workbook here. So I'm just going to minimize this down to my taskbar right here, okay? Or if I wanted to, I could close out of it, but it's best to minimize it because when I double-click to open this up, now I have two workbooks opened up, Excel workbooks. I have my one to my chart here, and then over here I can click on this button to my monthly sales. It's linked to my table. So all I have to do is select it, click on the copy button, but you know what? I don't want the title in there. I just want the data here. So I'll select it again and click the copy button one more time so the marching ants are just around this selection here. If I don't have them both open where I can click copy here and then I come and open up the other one, it's not going to work when it comes to pasting. It won't give me the paste button. So just leave both of them up. I'm going to come up here in the upper left-hand corner in cell A1 and paste, and it will paste down and out, so it pushes it out. And as you recall, if you watch the other training videos for Microsoft Excel, that when we're creating charts, basically it's got this blue border, thin blue border, everything within it is going to be within your chart. So if I move this around, see there's category 4 right there, isn't there? So I'll bring it back up, and I don't want category 4 in there. I can do one of two things. I can either select it and delete it, or I can click out and grab this little corner handle of the blue and move it up one. So the data's still there, but when I move it out of the way, the data isn't in the chart. And if I want to expand it more, I can, of course, click it out. But just keep in mind that, as you recall from the other training videos, that this corner doesn't go diagonally. You have to do it. You have to either go out or down. And then once you go down, then you can click it and drag it out. You have to go one way or the other. And then once you're done with that, then you can go the other way. So once I'm finished, I can go ahead and close out of there. And of course, this is my monthly sales to my table, which has nothing to do, I'll close out of that, with my chart here. Two separate Excel workbooks, two separate data fields. Although they look the same, don't they? Well, that's the whole point, the master of illusion here. Just know that if you want the data here in your table to be representative, or any data, just make sure that you insert your chart and it gives you that Excel workbook that you paste, or just type in that Excel workbook. In fact, if we want to make changes to your chart, you want to, when in doubt, right-click and always edit the data, and it brings up your workbook. And then you can make changes in here. So if 800 is too high, and I'm looking at May, so 800 for the south. So if I come in here and say, well, you'll be 50, and I hit the tab key, then I can move it out of the way. Well, there I am. It's increments of 50 here, so it's right at the margin.
Thanks for watching.
Hey, as a quick reminder, if you like my video, please give it a thumbs up. You can also click on me and subscribe to my channel, get notified of the latest videos, and for only $2 a month, you can have access to all my Microsoft Office training videos.